shockingly, also included in this fine ensemble is Alan Jones on the drums. And of course, we have a very special guest up here, all the way from Los Angeles, California. Please welcome Taylor John Williams. I said this at the first show, but I especially mean it this time. Not so much then, but I can't do anything about that. But now I really mean it, because it's going to be immortalized on YouTube and Facebook, and you know what goes there never dies. So if we could please make this a listening room so that everybody on the internet can hear the music too, that'd be great. Otherwise, you could embarrass yourselves forever. We can't have that. That doesn't mean don't celebrate great moments if there's a crushing solo or the regular celebration at the end of a song, like not the kind that's like, thank God it's over, but more like the, you know, hey, that was really great, we should celebrate. That kind of clapping and applaud, that's all fine. Anyway, I'm going to stop talking. Thank you for coming out tonight. Please give it up for Taylor John Williams.
Okay. Shouldn't we tell you this time? Come on. You already thought of that, huh?
I would like to dedicate this entire show to the internet. All of it. I think, are there any singers in here in any capacity that aren't weird about singing in public? You don't have to, cool.
Yeah.
I like that. I was gonna say you don't have to raise your hand, and then you raised your hand, which was awesome. You even did a hang loose sign. Everybody who wants to sing this song, I think, should, because it really adds to the quality of the, you guys in? Do you guys know it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas? Sick.
And while Randy's doing his intro, we have to set the stage.
Let's set the stage.
I
don't have anything to drink.
Like you're playing a pub. You have something to drink.
We're in a pub. So have you guys heard the record? The Christmas record? Anybody who has the oh. Oh yeah. If you haven't, pretend you have. The setting is, let's all get in character for a second. Randy's setting the tone. Let's get in character. We're in an Irish pub. We've been drinking far too long. And some dude with far too few buttons on his suit, because they popped off in the last set, says, let's sing a song about how Christmas is just about to start. And you say, ha! And then we go, And then Randy starts to does that.
He keeps going.
But he keeps going because he's playing an intro. And then I, just sing it, even if you don't know the words. Just do it. Come on. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go, take a look at the 5 and 10. It's glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes that glow. Come on! It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. What's in the toys in every store? But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. There are bubble is the wish of Bunny and Ben. Dolls that'll talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Ben. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Come on! Everywhere you go, there's a tree at the Grand Hotel, one in the park as well. It's the sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start, but the thing that'll make them ring is the carol that you sing right within your heart. This is Randy Porter. Listen to him play. Thank you.
This happened on the last show too. He knows I don't understand jazz music, and so he just fucking... So tonight, since we don't place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Oh, run, but I brought some corn. Lots of turn way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, I'm all ain't going out in the storm. But if you really owe me time, all the way home I'll be born. Oh, the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Going out in the storm, but if you really hold me tight, all the way.
my dear, we're still goodbye. As long as you love me so, let it snow. Let it snow. Let it snow. Let it ride. Thank you guys very much for being here. We had a great first show together as a band. My first time ever at the 1905. Have a lot of you guys been here before? Cool. Well, I hope this is at least going as well as anything that you've ever been here to see before.
Yes.
Alan Jones, everybody. We're going to play a song that is not an original. It's called White Christmas. None of us had anything to do with writing this song. But Mike Gamble does this really cool thing at the top of the song where he goes, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, da, da, da. But he didn't do it just then. But this time he will, because it goes, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Like the ones I used to know, where the tree tops listen and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. Ooh, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white. good band. This is a really good band. Is that Ben? Hell yeah, what up? I thought you were in San Francisco. You're not. I'm sure of it. We have a song that's also not an original called Chestnuts, called The Christmas Song. And we're going to play that for you, and Randy's going to play something really beautiful for a little bit, because he's just simply one of the best piano players around, and he deserves as much time to play things by himself. No, four bars?
That's it?
Four.
Five?
16. 16. She called it. You get 16 bars of this.
Okay.
I'm going to go take a nap.
That's a long time.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey. Merry Christmas.
I really wanted to sing Ave Maria because I love the song very much. I think it has one of the most beautiful melodies ever written of all time. And so I said, let's do this on the record. And then we got into the studio, and the problem was that I had been studying the Josh Groban version, and so I tried to sing it like Josh Groban, but I can't sing like Josh Groban. So it ended up sounding stupid. And I said, we did our takes of it, and I said, Alan and I looked at each other and the band, you guys were all cool, but Alan and I were like, I don't think this is working. And then he said, why don't you try something else? So he told me to try something else, and I went back into the studio and re-recorded the vocal, and it worked. And I said, cool, this isn't as stupid anymore. And he's a very smart man, and he's a very good musician. And it was really cool to collaborate with somebody so deeply on a piece of work, which I've never done before. We've done stuff in the past. We've made a couple records in the past. Song of a Dead Man and Heareth. Does anybody know in those? Tight! Yeah! 4 out of 40 is not that bad. Because I suck at math. Anyways, that was the first two projects that we did together. I hijacked basically the entire creative process because I was very bossy, and I'm still very bossy, but now I know the benefits and the glory of dishing off some of the work to somebody who is also very strong-willed and knowledgeable about what they're doing, and that's something that I'm still learning about and growing. I'm growing out of my own head, which is weird. The point being, I'm so thankful that Alan was willing to do this record with me, and this was truly the most collaborative piece of work that I've ever been a part of. So A Very Christmas by Taylor John Williams and the Alan Jones Quartet is very much that. We are 50-50. We fucking did this thing together, and I'm so happy about it, and I hope you guys have been enjoying it. So give a round of applause to Alan Jones, please, for his work on this record. Let's play some more music.
Said, this might be my favorite song on the record.
Yeah.
I don't know that he still feels that way, but he did say that.
I don't. But it doesn't matter. Thank you. A whole lot. This is late and it's Thursday, so it's really fucking cool that you guys all came to this. Really, really appreciate it. Thank you very much. And some of you stayed for both shows, and it's fantastic. This is the part of the show where we loosen up a little bit. And Tom Wakeling, everybody. Can I give it up for Tom Wakeling on the bass? Yeah, I like that. I feel like it's a little bit sped up from last time, too. I like it. How are you feeling, Tom? How are you feeling, Tom? Show me how you're feeling. Hey, come on. Come on. Children would nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. Mom in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what's the matter. Way to the window, I flew with a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster midday to the objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, well, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers, they came. And he whistled, and he shouted, and he called them by name. On Dasher, on Dancer, on Prancer, and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner, and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away. Dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet to an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the rooftop, the courses they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and Saint Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and the pawing of each little poof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney Saint Nicholas came with a bound. Now I gotta tell him what Saint Nicholas was about. I have to tell him what Saint Nicholas was about. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had slung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. Exactly. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His throat, little mouth, was drawn up in a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. Little belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. Chubby and plump, but right, jolly old elf. And I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to care. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work. Filled all the stockings and turned with a jerk, and laying a finger to the side of his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose, sprang to his sleigh, and to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim as he rode at a sight, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night." gonna do a. My dream is that at some point, a director called Tim Burton will say, "I want to do a live-action Grinch movie," and I want it to be an actor. It doesn't matter who the actor is, but I thought maybe it would be Benedict Cumberbatch, and he would have green hair, and the opening scene would be him in a bar, and he's shit-faced, and he's dealing with some alcohol abuse problems, and. It's kind of a darker take on the Grinch, as if you were a real person, you know? Instead of a weird bear thing. And he's having all these issues in his life. And then I say, Tim Burton, this is a great screenplay. You should use this song. And it goes like this. Alan says, one. First we all have to do this. Can everybody keep time with Alan right now? Gonna switch it up on you at some point and you're all gonna be pissed, but just ready for it.
One, two, three, four.
Thank you.
keeping it real. Give it up for this band. God damn. We got Mike Gamble on guitar. We got Tom Wakeling on the bass. We got Alan Jones on the drums. And we've got Randy Porter on the keys. And this is my first time playing at the 1905, and what an honor to play with such fantastic musicians. This has been great, but we're not done. Now we're going to do something a little bit, dare I say, skanky? What's the word? Skankalicious? I'm not sure if anybody truly likes this song, but I decided that I wanted it on my record. So it's on the record. And it goes like this.
Thank you.
Thank you. Going freestyle, guys. I got like 3 buttons left on my suit and I'm going freestyle. I wrote a Christmas song. I'm gonna do that again, and it's not because I want you to clap, but I'm gonna do it again anyways. I wrote a Christmas song. And it's like a Hollywood movie. I'm trying to differentiate from what I said last time, but maybe I'll just say the same thing that I said last time, because there's people here that were at the last show, and it makes me very, very. I know, but it makes me feel very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
There's like a funny extra ball.
This is about.
We had that. It came out right last time, I think. I played it. I read it down.
This is like when, in the Parent Trap. Meet the Parents. Not the Parent Trap. This is like when in Meet the Parents, Ben Stiller tries to win the affections of his Bonnie Lass's parentals, and they're like, they're not into it. And most of the movie, they're not into it. But then at the end of the movie, he figures it out and they're into it. This song is like if the end of the movie never happened. It's called Our Very First Christmas. And I'm gonna ditch the mic stand, I think, maybe for the rest of the show, because I already don't have a lot of room to move my limbs up here, but now I do. I have more. I'm talking out loud. These are things I could just say in my head. No. This is called Our Very First Christmas. Okay? Yeah, I like that. I really want this to be your guys' favorite song, so.
Together might have come
Thank you very much. Merry Christmas, I guess. Who's the moron? Who's dad? Oh, in the song. Oh, yeah, yeah. This is not a true story, so you're not talking about anybody real. You're dissing on a hypothetical dad, which is a cool punk rock band name. Dissing on a hypothetical dad. What do they go? What do they go? She's still. Kelly's such a devout fan of the music that I make, and it's so beautiful and humbling to see it. But she's so devout that even when I write songs about fake people who break my heart, she wants to fight them. Pretty cool. I can't tell you. I can't say many people have friends in their lives that would fight the hypothetical person trying to fuck with your life. It's nice. This is a song about Christmases that are less than white. They're on the other end of the spectrum. And Elvis said it best. And we're gonna play it for you right now.
Without you, I'll be so blue. Just thinking about you, decorations array on a green Christmas tree. singing over us start falling.
Thank you, guys. We have a couple more songs for you, and we cannot thank you enough for sticking it out with us for this long on a Thursday, which I don't even do. I don't do this. I go to bed at 9 o'clock every night. So I really should be thanking myself for being here for this long. So if you guys wouldn't mind thanking me real quick, I'd really appreciate it. Thank you. Oh, you don't need to do that. No. You don't need to do that. We're going to play a song called Silent Night, and this is not an original. Have you guys heard this one before? Okay. Thank you. We have one more song for you. One more time. Please give it up for Mike Gamble on the guitar. Tom Wakeling on the bass. Randy Porter on piano. And my good friend and collaborator and I just love the man, Mr. Alan Jones on the drum. Mike and I are going to play one more song for you, and then we're going to be on our way. Merry Christmas to you all. Thank you very much for being here. Troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Shining star upon the highest bough. And have yourself a merry little Christmas now. You better play us something. A shining star upon the highest bough. Thank you guys very much. Really appreciate y'all. Thank you to the 1905. Thank you for making us sound good. Thanks for feeding us food and drink. Thank you for everything. Really appreciate you spending this night with us. Merry Christmas. Love you guys. Thank you.